Yo, what's good? It's Tracy Lee. It's party time. You know what you're rocking with in the club TV.
Hey. What up? It's Derek D. Angeletti. Brooklyn style, hip hop. Not rapping style, too, baby. You know what I'm saying? In the club TV, we in here. Hip hop all day, every day.
You get another chance tomorrow. I don't hustle like that. I hustle like this. There's not a second left. You know that tomorrow I'm hustling like there's only one more second left of this hustle.
Hey everybody, this is your girl Deborah Coco, and we are here at Symphony Space for the golden age of hip-hop. This is all put together by Monopoly Records and Soup Inc. It is about to go down. Hip-hop culture is definitely in the building. First coming up is Bad Boys, Tracy Lee, Mr. Cheeks, Antoinette, Positive K, K-Solo, and Yo-Yo. And then we got more. We also have Dana Dane, we got Smith & Wesson, and we got Jungle Brothers. They are here at Symphony Space. Like I said, it's about to go down. And I'm your girl, Deborah Coco. Y'all stay tuned. We got more coming up. Sitting here with Tracy Lee. He just got off stage doing his thing. I love your performance tonight. The energy is party time. I know you got some other good hits too, but it's party time. That song just like gets in your bones or something and make you want to get up and do your thing. Like, did you realize that song was going to be such a hit like that when you made it? It looked like you was having fun in the video.
I mean, nah, I didn't actually. You know what I'm saying? Matter of fact, the origins of me being an MC was always, like, back then it was always like, you know, I just want to spit the hot fire, you know, the flames and all that.
Right.
But then D-Dot, who was on stage with me, you know, he mastered the art of record making by, you know, being a hitman and all that other stuff. And we came up, well, I found a sample, which was Pieces of a Dream. And then he added some other samples, like the Buffalo World Famous Supreme Team and all that.
Nice.
But he made the groove so crazy that, you know, I knew we had something, but a lot of my crew, they was like, nah, Trey, nah, that's soft, da 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 da. None of them, like, yo, it was like three. It was like, I'll tell you, about out of 20 people, it was probably like three that was like, yo, that, you know what I mean, that was hot, but everybody, oh, that's soft. But then they started playing it on Hot 97.
And that was it.
And then I swear, the very next week, them same people that was like, oh, that's trash, it was like, yo, Trey, that's just,
yeah, like
exactly.
This, right?
Exactly.
So how do you feel today? Because like I said, we talked a little bit earlier off camera, and I see you on social media, you promoting new music, you still putting out some great music. So how do you feel about hip-hop today?
I think it's in a great place, and I'll tell you why. Because we have the ability to put it out there ourselves. The net, you know what I'm saying, technology has allowed us as artists to be more independent, to center or gravitate toward our artist, our audience directly, and therefore it cuts through the fat, it cuts through the middleman, so you can get your music to the people that want to get it initially. And then what happens is it's a domino effect, because and listen, people are naturally followers, you know what I'm saying? There's very few people that can, you know, off the break be like, oh, it's hot. A lot of people need to be coerced into thinking something is hot or not. You know what I mean? So if you get an audience that's really with you and behind you, and you're giving out and you're giving them quality product, then eventually if you stay consistent with it, people will follow. You know what I'm saying? Absolutely. That, and that's why you see me on IG a lot. It's like I see the tool. I understand how to use it. Just keep giving them content. Keep
you
giving
have
them
the
content.
Control. Marketing for all aspects of your career as an artist.
Yeah,
right?
But see, a lot of people, they don't want that. Like, they say they want it until they get to it or get involved with it or see what it takes.
Right.
Then it's like, oh, I don't know if I want this. I think I want to get with a record label so they can do all the work.
Like, I can just be an artist.
Yeah.
Some people do prefer just to be the artist. They don't have that business.
But then, but then the flip side is that,
right?
And your bread is short.
True.
Because then you get more hands.
Person,
exactly.
This person, that
exactly.
Person.
Exactly.
So how do you feel about the industry? All the changes that's been happening in the industry when it comes to deals and getting signed, things like that.
I think it's for those who want to go that route, and mainly that's, and I'm not even gonna say it's the young kids. Because, you know what I'm saying, but the young kids, because the young kids understand how to use the technology. So there's a lot of them kids that's going an independent route. But they still may not have the knowledge or the wherewithal to understand how to market, how to promote, how to get it to your audience. Exactly.
Together, right.
So when I get clients that are younger and they come and they say, well, you know, I have a deal on the table, what have you, first thing I tell them is, okay, do you own your publishing? That's the first thing I ask them off the bat. If you're going to sign away your publishing, make sure you negotiate it the right way. You know what I'm saying? You want to get paid for a property that's yours. You want to get paid for it if you decide to give it up. Next thing I say is, what do you want, fame or do you want the money? You know what I'm saying?
Right.
If you want the money, I suggest you stay independent.
Right.
If you want the fame, then go ahead. Go, you know, be that. Give them a couple.
That machine will push you.
It will.
Hey,
it will.
You sign with somebody, you will get pushed.
But
be
prepared for that product to be the sacrificial lamb.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right. No, you're right.
And as long as you have that head, you're in that headspace, then you're fine. But if you go into it thinking that you're going to sign with a label and you're going to own all your masters and you're going to own your publishing and all that, you got another thing coming.
So how is it for you? Because you have the legal business sense.
Mm-hmm.
And then you artist, so you like, you know, do you cover? I know you cover yourself, of course,
yeah.
But like, how does it work for you being on both sides of it?
It's a beautiful thing for me.
Mm-hmm.
When I'm dealing with a client, though, it's like I straddle the fence, because from an artist perspective, I'm like, nah, man, don't sign away nothing, keep all your paper.
Right.
But then from the legal perspective, again, I say, I give you all sides of the coin.
And
let you make the decision.
Okay.
But you can't tell me that I didn't give you the advice first. And that's one thing that I was missing. I wasn't told the full story.
Right.
So
right.
I want to give my client the full story so you can make an informed decision.
Very,
you know what I'm saying?
So what are you working on today?
Oh, man. Got some projects coming down the line. Like I said, I'm working on a project with D-Dot. It's going to be crazy. It's going to be classic.
Okay.
It's going to be that, you know, that classic sound, that party time feel, but 2018.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
All right.
And some other, you know, projects that I'm going to keep on the hush until we get all the paperwork
stay
straight.
Tuned,
you know what I'm saying?
Right?
Stay
they
tuned.
Stay tuned.
Stay
and where
tuned.
Can they follow you on social media?
Man, you can go to IG, Tracy Lee, ESQTRACEYLEESQ. You can also go to Trey Lee at TRAYLEE for Twitter. You can go to Facebook, Tracy Lee. And you can go to my company website, LLEFTENT.com. That's left spelled with two L's, ENT.com.
Check him out, y'all. We are in the building, Symphony Space. It is going down. And you're going to see some of his performance a little bit later, too. We'll be back.
Snatches, the damn, 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 the Keep your hands high, you don't want to die. Keep your hands high, ain't nobody walking this main cross alive. So you know it's bringing me out. Keep sleeping on your feet while I try. Keep your hands high, you don't want to die. cream busting out the scene. Now let me hear it.
Over the down, walk, and so we're gonna do all the right.